What's up everybody and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to draw a digital illustration of your pet. So let's get started. Go ahead, open up your Procreate, and let's start a new artboard. So I'm just going to choose an 8.5 by 11 artboard. Go ahead, add an image by clicking the wrench tool, add, and then insert a photo. And go ahead and navigate to your beautiful pet photo. I'm just gonna scale this up a bit. Okay, so now I'm gonna add in a reference photo. So go to Canvas and then turn on the reference switch. A new window will pop up in your artboard with the same adorable pet photo. However, we're not gonna use this because whenever we draw on our artboard, it will draw onto the reference as well. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna click Image, Import Image, and then just navigate to our image again. And there we go. So now when we draw on our artboard, it will not affect the reference image at all, which is what we want. All right, so let's start drawing. The first thing I'm gonna do is lower the opacity of my image just so I can see what I'm drawing a little better. When I do these flat illustrations, I like to break it down into single shapes. So I'm gonna do a shape for the head, a shape for the ears, and so on. So first I'm gonna start with the head and just name this layer. Then I'm gonna choose a nice color for the face as well as a nice brush. And I just like to use the script brush. I'm gonna start by going around the perimeter of the head, just tracing any of the hairs along the way. Just note that I'm not going to include the ears in this first shape. I'm just focusing on the main shape of this dog's face. So this puppy has a lot of long wavy hairs and it's making the outline really jaggedy, but just know that if your dog's hair is really short, the outline of the face may be more smooth. All right, so that's the first shape. I'm just gonna drag and drop the color to fill really quickly so we can start on the ears. And I'm just gonna include the bottom lip in this layer too. So go ahead and start a new layer underneath the head layer. And I'm going to call this ears. Just like last time, we're gonna choose a nice color from the reference image, and then we're gonna start tracing the outline of the ears. Okay, so I'm gonna speed up this time lapse quite a bit because I'm just gonna repeat this process for the rest of the shapes. So I'm gonna finish up with the ears, then move on to the neck, then the collar, the chest, the front legs, and then the back legs, putting all of these shapes on separate layers. I like to break these illustrations into several different sections because I think it makes it more manageable when you can focus on one section at a time. Your illustration may be looking a little funky at this point, like mine, because mine uses like several crazy random colors and such. Yeah, it's kind of weird, but just know it'll all come together in the end. Alright, so we're done with all the simple shapes. Now, we're gonna turn off all of those layers we just created, except for the head layer. We're gonna start adding some details to this illustration to bring it to life. Alright, so we're just gonna add a layer above the head layer, and I'm just gonna call this head shadows. Next, I'm gonna eyedrop the color of the face, and then choose a color that's a couple notches darker that we can use for these details. Then I'm gonna lower the opacity of the head layer so I can see through to the image below. And I'm just gonna start filling in some of these darker areas. You'll notice there's a few darker spots around the eyes, around the nose, around the mouth, and you can even look at your reference image to kind of see some of the darker areas as well. So yeah, I'm just gonna kind of start going around these darker areas, tracing the shapes, making them look all nice and fuzzy, and this is really gonna add some dimension to this artwork. Don't forget to kind of use your reference photo as a guide. It'll help you with placing shadows and different shapes, just to notice like what part of the image should be darker and should have more details and so on. I'm really just going through and tracing the shapes that I see, and yeah. It's kind of funny how in grade school, tracing was kind of frowned upon, but It works perfectly in instances like this, and it makes your art look really good. Now let's bring the opacity of the head layer back up, and yeah, looking kind of like a gremlin or whatever. This looks really crazy, but you just gotta trust the process. Now let's move on to adding some details to the ears. Just like before, we're gonna create a layer on top of the ears, and guess what we're gonna name it? That's right, ears shadows. I like to get real creative when it comes to naming layers. I know it. Anyways, choose a color that's a couple notches darker than the ear layer, and then just lower the opacity of the ear layer so you can see what you're drawing. I think you guys kind of get the gist of what's happening, so I'm just gonna speed this up quite a bit and then show you guys how to handle the eyes and nose, because that can be kind of tricky. Alright, so the eyes and the nose are probably the hardest part of this entire drawing, but I got confidence in ya. We're gonna build this nose kind of backwards. So we're gonna start with the nostrils, then we're gonna add the highlight underneath the nostril layer, and then we're gonna end with the base nose shape. Alright, got it? Let's go. So I'm just gonna add a new layer, name it Nostrils. Then I'm actually gonna go ahead and turn off all of these layers just so they aren't distracting. And then you know what to do. Draw in the two nostrils. And I know most dogs have that nostril line. You can draw that in if you have that, but I'm good on this one. Then what we're gonna do is add a layer underneath the nostrils layer and call it nose highlights. We're gonna grab a nice highlight color and just add it in all of the places that are kind of light. So I'm gonna add them underneath the nostrils here, and then this big area on top of the nose. To finish up the nose, we're just gonna add the last layer underneath the highlights layer. I'm gonna call it nose. Grab a nice base color and then trace the nose. Little cartoon nose looks so cute on this dog, I can't. Anyways, we're gonna treat the eyes the same. We're gonna start with the highlight, add the pupil, the eye, and then the eyelid. Did you follow that? Okay, let's go. So let's make a layer, and we're gonna call this layer Eye Highlights. Go ahead and grab a color from your reference photo, and I'm just gonna simplify the shape of these highlights just to make them look a little nicer. Next up, underneath the highlight layer, we're gonna make a layer and call it pupil. And I think you know what this is. Just add a nice pupil. Continuing on, under the pupil, we're gonna add a layer called eye color. And this is just gonna be, you know, the eye color. I feel like these layers are kind of self-explanatory, but anyways. You'll notice that a few hairs are actually overlapping the pupil on this side, and I'm actually gonna keep those hairs in the illustration. So yeah, I'm just drawing around those. Okay, we're almost done with the eyes. Under the eye color, we're gonna create a layer called eyelid highlight. As you can guess, we're gonna do this little highlight on the eyelid. And to finish off the eyes, we're gonna add the eyelid layer. And this is just gonna be the outer, like the darker outer rim around these eyes. I didn't really know what to call it, but yeah. Okay, I don't know if this tutorial is getting too long. Do you guys know how to group? We're just gonna select the layers by sliding them to the right and then pressing the group layer. And then you can rename the layer by just selecting rename. So I'm just gonna draw this mouth in really quickly and then continue on adding details to the rest of the layers. So I'm going to continue focusing on one layer at a time, adding the shadows to the neck, adding shadows to the collar, and so on. At this point, I decided to do a little color adjusting because there was nothing golden about this golden retriever. So just press on the wand, hue saturation, and layer, and as you can see, I'm just kind of adjusting the saturation until I get a more yellow color. You can also adjust the brightness, but I decided not to do that. Another way to adjust color is by eyedropping and then just dragging and dropping the color into your shape. To finish up this artwork, I'm just going to choose a background color. And I actually wanted a blue that matched the collar, so I'm going to go ahead and eyedrop the color of the collar, go to the values tab, and then just copy this little code called the hexadecimal. Just now go to your background layer, go to values again, and then just paste that same code into the hexadecimal. And there you go. The color matches the collar. But, of course, we change our mind all the time, so you can see that the background and the collar is red now. We're going to add our pet's name to the top of the artboard. So go to the wrench tool, go to add, and then add text. You'll see a little text box pop up, and that's where you can type in your little pup's name. So now just triple click on your name, go to the double A in the corner of the keyboard, and then this will bring up a menu where you can choose your fonts, the font size, and all that good stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and change my color really quickly. I thought my text looked really big, so I'm gonna go back into this font menu and just adjust the size a bit. I also decided to switch to all caps and then adjusted the tracking a bit to add more space between the letters. The last thing we're gonna do is export this image. So go to the wrench tool, go to share, and then choose JPEG. A menu will pop up asking you where to save. I'm just gonna press Save Image, and this should drop it right into your photo gallery. So I'm gonna open that up real quick, and there it is. Okay, I just wanna thank you guys for watching this video. Peace out.